Hi, I'm Engineer Bill. I've run into a dilemma. I am overworked, even though I'm semi-retired, and I can't work any more hours than I'm already working. If you look at my printer back here, the printer has taken over the shop doing the labor that I would do manually. As an example, this is what I had a couple years ago. This is a, we'll call it a fan blade, but it would be pretty tough to make a whole lot of these in a quick amount of time. The 3D printer will make them for me. Formerly I did this with wood. Once I designed this, I put it on the 3D printer, and it takes a while to print, but it's doing it for me, and it frees me up to do other things. So I'm relying more and more on the 3D printers. That don't get me wrong about 3D printers, they only print plastic, really. Some of the plastic has fillers in it that make it a little bit stronger, different qualities, but really it's just still plastic, and people get really upset when they say, I don't want to put plastic in there, I want metal. But yield of material is a yield of material. Steel has a yield, plastic has a yield. As long as you design to the yield of the material, plastic's fine. So, unfortunately, since I'm relying more on my 3D printer all the time, I've had it for a couple years now, it's not keeping up with my projects. What did I do? I went and bought another one. Not the same one, something a little different with a little different capacity, and this one that I have behind me, that's an expensive one. This one is much, much cheaper. So I haven't opened it up yet, and this really isn't a open up video. This is just about 3D printers. And let me be clear about a 3D printer in the shop. If you have one of these in your shop, and if you have one of these in your shop, and maybe a table saw, then why in the world do you not have a 3D printer? The 3D printer is really big in my shop. I think I know why you don't have a 3D printer in your shop. But first, let's open up this box. Get some of the stuff out of the way. Now I'm not, this is just a 3D printer to me. I'm not looking at it as some kind of toy. Oh boy, I can't wait to play with it. I want to put it to work. I want it to work for me, and I'm anxious to get it producing. Yeah, I did review all the 3D printers that I can buy. I wanted to get a dual extrusion 3D printer. I couldn't find one that was good enough for me. They either have too small of a bed. The only reason why I wanted a dual extrusion printer is because I wanted the extra production capacity. But for the cost and for what it does and for the quality, I'm better off. If I want extra capacity to buy another 3D printer with a single extruder, more cost effective to do it that way. As far as different colors, that's for the kids to play with. I have no need for different colors. If I need to do something like that, I'll paint it. Now, I'm not going to recommend printers to you. Everybody has different needs and qualities, and there's all kinds of different printers. Should not be this is the best printer. It's you have to do your research and find out what is best for you. Now, this one has a bigger printer bed. That's it. I'm going to put this together and get it warmed up and tweaked and all that stuff. Then I'm going to talk about why you don't have a 3D printer in your shop. You should, but I understand there's some complexities. Maybe I can help you undo some of those complexities. Okay, I'm back. I'm sorry, I'm not in the shop. I'm at a conference. I'm at the beautiful Sawgrass Country Club. This is a view from my room. Not bad. This is where I'll be working all week. But I wanted to get this video out, and I wanted to make this kind of a short video anyway. So I apologize I'm not out in the shop. I'm trying to use my time as best as I can. We're talking about 3D printers. And I'm trying to convince you, especially if you're on the fence, to get a 3D printer for your shop. I have to use a 3D printer all the time because I just can't keep up unless I hire four or five of me or clone myself to keep up with the projects that I'm working on. So maybe this is a couple of the reasons why you do not have a 3D printer. One is because the cost. The cost is nothing now. A couple of years ago it was more expensive. Now the 3D printer I bought was $700 or $800. It was well under $1,000. My first printer was $2,000 to $3,000. That's US dollars, of course. And the new one is, I hate to say this, but better than the old one. And I think what I'm going to do, my next video, when I get back to my shop, I'm going to do something I promised myself I'd never do. And I'm going to do a review of the printer I just bought. And I'm not going to do a review just because I like the printer and I want to show what the printer can do. I am doing the review because I read so many reviews on this printer and a lot of other printers too that were just absolutely terrible. And you really want to know an engineer's point of view. These guys that are doing the review had no engineering skills at all that I can tell. The reviews were just terrible without skill or knowledge. So I'm going to do a review and I'm going to explain why those people got it wrong and what the engineering perspective is. Okay, aside from that, why don't you have a 3D printer? Except for the cost. Okay, there's some cost. Option is, where can you use 3D printers? It's plastic. There are 3D printers that do metals now, but we're not going to discuss that. That's still at the elite level. Right now, it's all plastics and plastic with fillers, and you can make them pretty strong. But, you know, here's what I have right over here in my second camera. I made a stand for it. Where am I going to get the stand for it that is custom to what I need? You know, I was able to print that out. You don't need metal to do that. Plastic works just fine. But there are other applications where I use a lot of plastic. And as long as you design for it, the plastic will work. It'll do just fine. So after you get the 3D printer, then the hesitation might be, well, how do I operate it? How do I do that? It's more complicated. You can't just hit a button and say, build it for me. You got to tell it what to build. Well, right. You do have to use some kind of CAD system. Now, it used to be a couple years ago, the CAD systems were very expensive. I think the professional one I used from 15 years ago was like $4,000 or $5,000. That's almost $10,000 in today's U.S. money. You know, so that's very expensive, and I'm a professional at it, and it took a long time to get trained on how to use it. But the CAD systems are really much easier now. For one, if you know 15 commands, you can do probably 90% of your needs to build things. The second thing is the expense for having a CAD program. You do need a computer to run it, but there are all kinds of free CAD programs that will do the job for you out in the market now. You don't have to have a professional CAD program. In fact, let me show you this. I just downloaded a free CAD program just a few minutes ago, and it's called FreeCAD. And I took a look at it, and this is what I can do with it. And I spent maybe 20 minutes trying to figure certain things out. How do you draw the lines? How do you extrude? And if you can draw lines and extrude and do maybe just hit a button and do a chamfer or radius, then you've got a whole lot of it already done there. But you know what's kind of funny is the free CAD systems, at least this free CAD that I got, it's called FreeCAD and it is free. It will do everything. I mean, it'll do the upper level stuff, but it is so hard to work with. All right? My professional CAD system, if you can't
do what you need, some of the simple stuff within a day or two, then it, you know, what good is it? And this thing is just, it's hard to work with. My real expensive one is a lot easier to work with, but you can do it. My advice is if it takes you more than a day or two to figure out how to build simple things, not too complicated, but simple, which is mostly what you need for your shop, then forget it, go to another free CAD system. And actually, I haven't tried this one. It's Sketcher. I've had some people that have nothing to do with engineering or CAD programs say they like it a lot and they figured it out very quickly. I haven't tested it out. I just don't have time to do any more than I already did. Try to find those programs with some tutorials. Follow the tutorials for a day or two. If you don't have it pretty much down where you can do your simple things within 2 days, forget it. Even if you can't start building some stuff within 1 day, forget it, move on to something else. There's another program I'm going to show you. It's a free program, extremely difficult. I have to use it for organic stuff. It's called Blender. Blender is the same kind of program that special effects artists for movies will use. You can use it as a CAD system, but it's extremely difficult because with a CAD system, a typical CAD system, you just have a box and you're either taking material away or adding material and you're elongating it or making it shorter or extruding it. It's very easy to use, where the Blender program pretty much works on the endpoints of a line rather than focusing on the line or even a flat plane. It's all these indices, and it's very difficult to work with. I use it for organic applications. I'm still trying to figure out how to do everything. I don't know if I have enough time to give it to be able to use it for the applications that I use it for. But for organic modeling, like faces or structures like that, then it's very difficult to do it on a regular CAD system. So that's what I do. All right, so the CAD should not be an issue anymore. It's really easy. It's like building blocks when you're a kid. It really is that easy once you kind of get accustomed to some of the commands. The next thing you have to do is you have to go to a slicer. Now, these CAD systems, you can build something electronically and you can see it and you can move it around and you can do everything with it. But to go to the 3D printer, it has to go to another program that decides how to make it on the 3D printer. And they're usually referred to as slicers. And they'll put down one slice and they'll figure out another slice, and they'll do all that for you. But you have to move your program from the CAD system once it's complete and put it into the slicer. It's very easy. You can stick with defaults most of the time. My slicer, I think I you can get free slicers, slicer programs, that is. And I think I paid maybe $30 or $40 for my slicer program because I wanted something a little bit better. But you just drop your model in there and you can modify it a little bit to tell the slicer to put little platforms or for if you're going to do a bridge, build something temporarily to hold it, and then you can break it off later on when you want to. And there's a couple of things like that. And then you send it over to the printer. And my new printer, I put the card in and I tell it this is the program I want. I hit start. That's all I do. My old printer, I have to go through another computer and then I have to do a lot more stuff to tell it to start. It's going to ask me a bunch of questions. I have to answer it, and it goes back and forth for a little while. And I set it up. And you know what? There's been several parts that I built maybe 5 or 6 of these parts, and they've all gotten used and they're very successful. Or maybe one broke and I had to beef it up, so I'd go back into the CAD system. It's already there. I would add another little bit more material and send it back out and have it built again. I am building things with the 3D printer that I don't have to build myself. I don't have to sit in front of a machine and walk the machine through, especially I'm referring to my end mill, through all the measurements and take measurements and be careful about this and that, I would be able to do the kind of stuff that I do, the experimental stuff, the one-off stuff, really complicated stuff, at least for prototyping, without the 3D printer. It'd just be impossible for me to do it. Get a 3D printer for your shop. Get one. You'll enjoy it. It'll work for you. Learn how to use it. Don't be intimidated by all this other stuff that you have to do. It's not that hard. And the benefits, boy, you'll wonder why you didn't have it in your shop to begin with. I think I'll go out for a little while and look around and see if I can find someone famous. We got golf clubs down here in one of the areas for show that Lee Trevino, Love, Jack Nicklaus, all those guys, yeah, Tiger Woods too. It's an incredible place. This is a world-class golf club. I can tell just from here, and I have a view overlooking it. This is a pretty nice conference to be at, but I'm still working. Nevertheless, thanks a lot for watching, and I'll try to get more videos out, but I'm strapped for time. I'm doing my best. See you later.